प्राइस फॉर दैट सीटीएफ वॉज द कार इट सेल्फ. समटाइम्स इवन अ सिंगल बग कैन अर्न यू 20 लैक्स और मोर.
Person should focus both on the cybersecurity aspects as well as. Hey guys, for more such insightful videos and videos covering opportunities for college students, please subscribe to Sahej's channel. And for topics which are not covered till yet, please put them down in the comments and we'll make sure that videos do come out next.
Definitely.
Hi guys, welcome to Sahej Oberoi's channel. And today we'll be having a podcast about cybersecurity and all the common questions you had. I'm Rohil Chaudhary and I'm currently working as an advisory analyst in the risk and financial advisory offering of Deloitte USI, the US offices of India. Over to you, Sahej.
Yes, so it's great to have you, Rohil. And many of my viewers had these questions about cybersecurity, like how could they pursue their career in this field. So here we are discussing about it today. So the very first question for you would be, what is cybersecurity? Could you just brief up about it?
Yeah, sure, Sahej. So cybersecurity is basically a field which can consist of techniques or practices which can help in defending computers, which can consist servers, mobile devices, some electronic systems, networks, and most importantly, your data from malicious attacks and unintended ways of accessing them. It can also be known as information technology security or information security.
All right. So what are the different fields in cybersecurity? Like, cybersecurity itself is a vast field, right? And within that also, there are few fields. So could you tell about it as well?
Sure, Sahej. I'll try to touch upon some of the most prominent fields in cybersecurity right now. One of them is network security, which is basically the practice of securing a computer network from intruders. And these intruders can be targeted attackers, which target these networks especially, and some of these can be malware, which are just targeting because of the backend in which they're working on. Then there's application security, which focuses on the softwares and applications running on devices. Then there is operating system security, which focuses on the malwares and the weaknesses which are persistent in an operating system. Then there are malware or spyware analysis. This is an interesting field which has a good scope and various opportunities. Cybersecurity also consists of risk, audit, and risk management. And this focuses on verifying all of the security controls are in place and performing audit activities.
All right. Now coming on to the next question. So there is also a common doubt whether programming languages are necessary to know if you want to pursue a career in cybersecurity. So could you give some light on this?
Yeah, sure, Sahej. So according to me, a person should have at least intermediate knowledge about programming and the logic that concerns it. It is also necessary for a person to have command or control over one chosen programming language of their choice, and then should also have some basic knowledge about two or three other programming languages, as this would help them in understanding code of different applications and then take out vulnerabilities from them. Or if they want to construct their own custom exploits, then this skill will come handy to them.
All right. So I hope this clears the common doubt of many people who want to start in cybersecurity. And another question that I wanted to ask was, how important is Python for a person who wants to get into cybersecurity? Like, I've also heard that Python plays a lot of role in cybersecurity. So again, could you share some ideas about it?
Yeah, sure. So as you know that Python is a growing language and is extremely popular in the coding world. So it is the same in cybersecurity world, and many of the exploits and the malwares that are constructed in Python. Python also has many inbuilt libraries which can be installed and do help in enhancing the experience and make it easier for a person to code something like an exploit or some testing script.
All right, thanks for that. And I have seen a lot of posts by people pursuing cybersecurity regarding Hack the Box. So could you tell me what exactly that is?
Yeah, sure. So Hack the Box is a website that provides a platform and a community which helps you to test your cybersecurity skills and take them to the next level. It also presents a gamified concept in which you can play games or hack into machines and test your knowledge and learn along the way. And it also provides hands-on training experiences using some labs.
All right, so this definitely sounds like a must thing for anyone who is interested in, pursuing their career in cybersecurity. And now it makes sense why many people are posting about this on LinkedIn. So the next question is about CTF. What exactly is CTF? And first of all, what is the full form of CTF?
Yeah, so CTF stands for Capture the Flag. It is a kind of cybersecurity game in which you have to complete a set of challenges which are often based on some of the concepts of cybersecurity like forensics and malware analysis or web security and application security. These are often given out as some vulnerable apps, and you have to identify the vulnerability, try to exploit it many a times, depends on the challenge actually, and then submit a flag to receive points or a reward. And it also is an essential part of building your knowledge as it tests your teamwork skills as well as the skill of quick thinking.
All right, and could you tell how a person can, start with CTF?
So there are many resources available on the internet, but according to me, you should definitely try out ctflearn.com as it offers challenges for all levels from complete beginner to absolutely advanced level.
All
Another
right.
website will be ctftime.com. It is a website which helps you to keep tab of all the currently going CTFs and how to participate in them live.
All right. I mean, even I recall that once there was a CTF organized by a Tesla, by Elon Musk, basically. So he organized a CTF for his own car to test the security of his own car, one of the models. And the price for that CTF was the car itself. So, I mean, even CTF can have great prizes, and
Definitely.
definitely it's something very interesting and a must try thing for you. All people who are interested in cybersecurity. So do try that, guys. And yeah, that reminds me, how has been your experience at CTF so far, and have you ever won one of them?
Yes, I sure. So it has been a wonderful experience playing CTS with my teams. And yeah, sure, I have many, and one of them that certainly stands out is that I secured the runners-up position in SCADA CTF, which was organized by IIT, and it was hosted in the NULLCON International Security Conference in the year 2020.
All right. So, is it some famous conference in the field of cybersecurity?
Yeah, it is the most famous conference. It happens all around the globe every year, and it is an international level conference.
All right. And what is your recommended path? Like, if you go back 4 years in the past and you, as a beginner, would want to suggest the correct path of learning cybersecurity or pursuing a career in cybersecurity. So, what would be your recommended way?
Okay, so according to me, the person should focus both on the cybersecurity aspects as well as keep and never lose touch with the coding aspects too in college life. If a person aims to start with cybersecurity in the very beginning, they should definitely start from either Hack the Box, or they can even try the website name TryHackMe. It is also a great learning platform, just like Hack the Box, but it also offers some learning paths. So these are some of the recommendations that I would recommend them to follow. After that, there will also be a recommendation that when they have chosen cybersecurity field, they should definitely carve out a niche for themselves in one of the areas in cybersecurity that will help them to grow and target their growth actually. And also to test out your skills in cybersecurity, always try to keep participating in CTFs actively. And you can also refer to some famous blogs to keep in touch with the current trends and news in cybersecurity. That will help you to gain insights in it.
All right, thank you. And what would be your recommended resources, which are really good quality and probably free of cost or at least minimal cost?
Okay, so two of the top resources would be the Discord server of Hack the Box, which
Okay.
has many channels related to resources, certifications, and different machines and different areas of cybersecurity all bundled into one server. So yeah, that's one to go for any kinds of doubt, as it remains active 24/7. And another one would be the subreddit of Hack the Box or TryHackMe. They are both great, great subreddits for getting information and getting your doubts cleared.
All right. So since you mentioned about certification, so could you tell me if certification is must in cybersecurity field?
No, says it is not a must to have certifications because skills are more important. But sure, from a corporate point of view, when you send out your CV and there are certifications mentioned in it, so that definitely help you stand out from the crowd and give you an extra edge over different people.
And what are the suggested certifications from your side?
If a person is just entering into the cybersecurity world and needs to have an edge over others, I would definitely suggest either the CEH, which is a Certified Ethical Hacker, or the Security Plus from CompTIA, and definitely the most famous one, the OSCP, which focuses completely on the hands-on skills of the person.
All right. Also, we missed out on another interesting thing, that is bug bounty, and it's really picking up pace in terms of, you know, getting more widespread among the cybersecurity people. So could you again brief up about it?
Yeah, sure. So as you told, it is completely right that it is quickly picking up pace because there are hundreds of posts that come up daily with different people posting that they have received this amount of bug bounty, they have received this amount of bug bounty. Yeah,
correct.
It is definitely one field in cybersecurity in which the people are get themselves enrolled into different programs and then try to find out bugs in different websites, and it completely focuses on the web application part of security. And different programs come up each day and people do tend to take out their time. And basically, bug bounty does require a different mindset from conventional cybersecurity and penetration testing.
And what is exactly Hall of Fame's? I guess it's part of bug bounty only.
Yeah, actually, some of the websites or programs offer Hall of Fame instead of a monetary reward. This, they recognize the person as they have helped them to identify some critical vulnerabilities in their website, and they honor them by posting their name or their social media handles on their website, which will be displayed there till the website stays up.
So that is definitely impressive. And guys, this is also one way of, you know, having career in cybersecurity, although I guess it's not that stable. So again, Rohil, if you could tell about it.
Yeah, so as Sahej mentioned, this is not a stable cause. Be times when you don't find some bug, and that can be a problematic thing because then there won't be any income or any bounty that you will receive. But there can be times where you find many bugs and there would be a massive increase in the number of bounties you hit. So definitely it is a nice thing to keep up to date with the skills you have and just keep it as a side hustle instead of a pure career-based option.
Right. And as Rohil said, there could be months where you don't earn anything. And sometimes even a single bug can earn you 20 lakhs or more. I'll add a screenshot somewhere here, which you can see. So it's very much unpredictable whether you might earn really good amount of money, and some days you might be broke as hell. So ultimately it's up to you if you want to pursue it as a full-time career, but according to me and Rohil, it is a very good side hustle which you can do perhaps on the weekends or once you're free from your regular work. So it can definitely add up to your side hustle thing, but for a full-time it's not a very recommended way. So finally Rohil is back with his haircut. And now we can start with the most important question, where, like, if a person is in second or third year of college, or perhaps in the first year of college, and he wants to do some internships, right? So how can a person proceed for that?
Okay, so that's a good question, and many people have asked me that before. So my advice would be simply work on your interests and start building a portfolio step by step. And the first step would be to have a mark in the industry. For example, say participate in some competitions, like in cybersecurity you can go for CTS or have some certifications, so you will have some portfolio that will be built and a CV to show. After that, you can send that CV to some openings in organizations where you can bag internships, which would align to the interests you have, keeping that in mind. And you will soon see replies coming back.
Right. And to get a more overview about this particular thing that Rohil has talked about, you know, about the interest and how you should follow the interest, so you can check another video of mine. There will be link somewhere here. So it's again about how you can get an internship at your dream company or startup. So it's more of a generic video, but still, like, some of the aspects of that video also definitely apply for cybersecurity. So the basic fundamentals for, you know, getting any internship is exactly the same. It's just that according to the field of interest, it just varies a little bit. So yeah, just check that video out as well. And now, once a person is done with his third or fourth year, right, and he wants to get placed in a good company, and let's assume that the on-campus company doesn't really come for cybersecurity at the campus of the student, right? So how can a person apply off-campus for cybersecurity roles only, for full-time of jobs?
Okay, so there are portals available at each company's website. You can keep looking and stay active, because that's the main thing, being proactive, and keep a lookout for those jobs and for those openings, and just send your resume to the stated mail. It's that simple. But yeah, you should keep in mind that when applying for the job, send a relevant resume so that the main skills are noticeable and your resume gets shortlisted among others too.
Yes, I absolutely agree with Rohil. I mean, just check the job description of the company, look out for the skills that they want. Mention those skills if you already have them, and if you don't have it, you can, you know, prepare basics of that particular skill and just mention that on your resume and then apply for the job, because obviously the company will prefer any student who already has those skills, right, over a person who has mentioned some skills which are not really required at that particular company. So just make a resume for a particular job description or a company, basically. So that's a very important point that usually the freshers miss, but it's really essential for getting selected off campus.